Hi there, Nathalie with you today with a new process video for Pink Fresh Studio. And today we're celebrating National Scrapbooking Day with a large online crop, and we're all hosting a different challenge. I am hosting the floral challenge, which means you gotta use any type of floral from the Pink Fresh Studio collections to create a layout. Now I'm gonna combine the My Favorite Story, because it has lots of beautiful florals, with the stitch square die set. And I had this idea, so I created something outside of the camera, and all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use the die set to create a few frames. So I'm just gonna show you how I went about creating. I'm gonna use the medium and the small size frames, and I want that stitch frame illusion for this. So I took it off camera, like I said, before I started working, and I cut three frames, three medium ones and three small ones. And my idea is I want to create a cascade of square frames and add all the florals around it. Now what I'm going to use this is I'm going to bring in a rainbow for this layout. So I'm going to use the Looking for Sunshine paper, and this is the one that has the beautiful rainbow stripes. And the way I'm going to cut it is I'm going to use the die, just because it's going to give me the perfect square, but I'm going to cut the paper in such a way that I'm going to create a rainbow throughout the entire square. So when I layer them together, they're going to form a square. So I had this idea of just creating a straight line of squares. I kind of play with a few ideas for this layout, but I know that regardless, I want to play with the colors of the stripes. So I'm going to take my time and just go ahead and start cutting every single one of the squares. And you're going to see right now how I'm going to cut them. I'm going to make sure that I can get at least two or three of the same of the different color color stripes when I cut the square. That way, when I mix them together, I'm able to layer them and create a rainbow on my page. Now you're gonna see that I'm gonna take my time. I play with a few papers. I have two of the papers. So already one already had cut out. So I play with the positioning of the frames, just to make sure, like I said, that I had the different color stripes and I can create that rainbow on the page. And I'm gonna take it off camera and just keep cutting it. And then you're gonna see when I come back that I have all the papers already cut down. And then you're gonna see how I'm gonna build them so that I create the background. And this it didn't take time. It's just, like I said, I debated and I played with a few ideas. So you're gonna see that I've cut each one of the squares has a little piece of one of the stripes. So the way I want to create it is I want to layer them. First I thought about a straight line, but then instead I'm actually gonna create something that's gonna give me a little bit of movement, just because I want layer the florals in between the squares. And I think the juxtaposition of those straight lines with the beautiful florals is gonna make it really stand out. So one of the things that I want to do is I want to make sure to pop some of the squares, to make things pop on this layout. And I started by adding a little bit of foam adhesive between the frame and the little piece of pattern paper. And you're gonna see that I was thinking I'm gonna put all of them, and then I was like, no, it's too much dimension. So instead I'm gonna glue some of the paper straight onto the frame, kind of back in the frame, and then in other ones I am gonna add the foam adhesive. This way it's gonna help me create that movement, kind of the dimension, the shifting and heights in the layout, and it's gonna look really nice at the end because you're gonna see all the layers. So I'm just gonna take my time to back each one of the pieces. The little blue square is gonna be straight onto the frame, so it kind of alternates. One's gonna be straight onto the pattern paper, the next one's gonna have dimension. It just worked out that way, so when I finish it just work one up, one down, one down, so there's that movement on the paper. So again, I'm gonna take it off camera and just finish backing the papers. And when I come back, I'm just gonna show you exactly how I'm gonna build the background. And then I'm gonna start adding some mixed media to this page. So you're gonna see how you see the movement. Some things are popping out, some things, there's dimension on the paper. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna use a ruler just to pencil down where everything is gonna sit, more or less an idea. I want this course to be kind of really linear and straight on the background. and then I'm gonna get messy. So I'm just penciling out, I'm using a ruler just to keep everything straight. And then what I'm gonna do is, I love using black ink and the backgrounds. It just makes everything stand out. So I am actually gonna bring the licorice, the liquid watercolor from Pinkfresh Studio to add some of the color on the background. And the way I'm gonna use it is, I'm gonna add a little bit of the watercolor. I'm gonna dilute it with some water, and literally I'm gonna use the watercolor to go around only the outside of the squares. I don't need to add the color inside because I know that the paper is gonna cover it. So I'm just gonna form. You're gonna see by the time it's all finished that I'm pretty much creating adding a shadow throughout the outside outline of the squares that I penciled down. And you know what, I really like the black. I know some people have an issue with that, but I think it's gonna make especially all the florals stand out really nicely. So I'm gonna take my time. I don't mind it if the color goes a little bit inside of the pencil line that I drew, because again, the pattern paper is gonna cover it, and you're gonna see that I don't use that much water. I'm gonna try it at best to stretch as much as I can of the watercolor, because I'm just using this is heavy cardstock, so I haven't added gesso, and I don't want to have that much buckling or warping on the paper. So I'm going to be very careful not to add that much water. And along the way, I'm going to add also some splatters, just because it's going to help me create that shadow kind of explosion look in the background. And I'm not going to cover the entire page. I just want to have enough of the black watercolor just peeking from behind the squares, so that when I put the flowers on top, it's going to stand out. I could have left it all white. I just thought that I needed something else. I needed some color just to make it stand out. So you're going to see that I am pretty much done. It takes very little. Like I said, I just wanted to create a little bit of shadow outside of the outline of the squares. And you can see it. I'm not being completely, 100% accurate about the square, but it's fine. So I'm gonna set it aside to dry for a little bit, and then I'm gonna go ahead and just start gluing the squares in place. And I'm gonna add a little bit of foam adhesive to some of the pieces, especially the ones that are back straight onto the frame, just because those ones are going to be above the other frames that have that shadow effect with the pattern paper. So I'm going to add a little bit of foam adhesive just to create, help me define the dimension. And one of the things that I'm going to try to be careful when I start building back the background is that create the sequence of the lines, recreate the sequence of the lines back on the layout. And I love that a good rainbow is always comes in handy, especially in these times when it's a little bit, we're going through a difficult time. And actually the picture that I'm documenting is my daughter. She was having a difficult time. Now it's still getting, it's a little bit hard. She's in her last year of high school. So this was the year that was after 10 years of schooling, she was gonna celebrate prom, graduation, all the things that come, with being in grade 12, none of them are happening. So she had a hard time. And it's one of the pictures of, I think, one of the first days when, the announcement came and school was canceled here in Toronto. She was having a hard time, and I just found her in some weird places because she can be weird sometimes. It's my daughter, I have to say it. But she's got better now. She understands. So going back to the layout. So now that I have the background ready, I am actually gonna pull all the florals from the ephemera pack from the My Favorite Story, and I'm just gonna decorate or embellish the layout. Remember, this challenge is all about using the florals, but I'm gonna place them around the squares in such a way that they follow the rainbow colors. And there's plenty of flowers in this collection to just go ahead and just create a rainbow of florals. And that's pretty much what I'm doing. I want to have the florals kind of peeking from behind the squares, kind of coming around the squares, and they're gonna add to the movement and kind of cut the linear lines of the squares. And actually you're gonna see that the black that I had that looked like lots, it's gonna start just kind of hiding behind all the florals, and it's gonna make everything stand out. Now I'm pretty much done with the florals. Now I'm gonna add a title, and I debated with some things to add, and I realized that the best title was not today, because really that's what she said, please don't talk to me today. So I'm just going to, you know, that's gonna be my title. I'm gonna use the beautiful white alpha that comes in the my favorite story collection, but I wanted something pink because the knot is gonna sit right on the pink stripe. So I pulled the mini alpha from the Noteworthy collection, and that just has, I'm gonna use the lighter shade of pink that kind of matches that area where I'm at in. Now, just to kind of accent the colors, I went and pulled the chipboard, the little circle chipboards, the embellishments from the My Favorite Story, and I'm gonna add them throughout the squares so that they match the color of the background. And that's just gonna be my repetitive element. I'm also gonna add a few enamel dots, and I'm really low on enamel dots. This is one of the most beautiful ones, but again, I'm gonna try to color match just to, you know, accent the idea of the rainbow. One of the things that I think I wanted to repeat too is when underneath the not today, I added that little peach sentiment. So I wanted a few more phrase stickers just to follow that line and have the repetitive idea. So I went and pulled, these are the puffy stickers, and there was a blue one, there was one that had white with the fuchsia letters, and there was another peach one. So it just help me to balance and repeat the elements. It's just gonna help with the idea of movement throughout the page. It's just gonna guide the eye throughout the page. And just to finish this layout, I'm actually gonna add my lines to the journal, two in between the peach and the blue line that has the perfect space there. And then I'm gonna add a few drops of a gold ink, just cause the alpha has that gold little flecks in it. And that's about it. I love how this turned out. It actually, like I said, I struggle a little bit with the idea, but at the end, I love how this turned out. I love the colors, I love the rainbow, I love the background, and I really love florals. And I hope you actually join in the challenge and take advantage of so many beautiful collections that Pinkfresh Studio has to create a project of your own. Add as many florals as you can. You can never go wrong with a floral and a rainbow. And I hope you try it. Don't forget to link your project to the blog to be able to win, enter the raffle for some prizes. I cannot wait to see what you create and have fun. There's so many challenges today that I think you're gonna have so much fun. Thank you so much for joining me, and I hope to see you soon. Take care, guys.